government agencies failed to spend 3.1 trillion shillings out of the 46.6 trillion shillings that was released to ministries, departments and agencies. The under-absorption of funds is attributed to COVID-19 restrictions, which affected implementation of quarter four activities. The Auditor General, John Muwanga, has released the annual audit report for the financial year ended 30th June 2021 in accordance with Article 163 of the Constitution.
Out of the 46 that was availed for spending, the entities, the MDS, could only spend 43.6, implying that there was unspent amounts that were returned amounting to 3.1 trillion. The under-absorption was largely attributed to the COVID challenges involving restrictions of movement, which affected the implementation of the activities.
Members received the report with disappointment, wondering how 3.1 trillion shillings could be swept back to the consolidated fund while Ugandans are crying for service delivery. They also castigated the Ministry of Finance for late disbursement of funds.
There has been a tendency of money being released to, for instance, local governments at a very late hour. You release money late and then you bring it back, maybe with intentions, because why would such a thing happen on earth? You release money when it's 1 week, when it's 1 month to the close of a financial year. Why would somebody do that? There are issues of contracts. People want to own all the contracts. And because of that, they are not quick to utilize the monies. And they come to Parliament and say, this one is unfunded priority, and yet you have money which you are returning to Parliament. And for me, finally, I want to ask that Parliament carries out a proper investigation, the committee on a pack.
You find that the accounting officers to districts are the cow, to cities or municipalities are the town clerks. So you find that some town clerks and some cow at the district levels, they bring in conflicts with the leaders they find there, the political leaders. And at the end of the day, those fights, it tends to, it affects the services, and it affects even appropriating the money which has been budgeted for in the financial year. So you find that the money is not being used, yet our people at the ground, they need the services. You find the money is not used, and at the end of the day, it is taken back to the consolidated fund.
In one financial year, the stock of the total public debt increased by 13 trillion shillings, which is 23.9%, from 56.9 trillion shillings up to 69.6 trillion.
2021 stood at 69.6 trillion, of which domestic debt or stock was 25.3, and external debt stock was valued at 44.3 trillion. This is an increase of about 13.4 trillion from the last year's debt of about 56.9. We note three things under debt. We note that although Uganda's GDP ratio is still below the IMF recommended point of safety, that is 50%, Uganda's GDP to debt ratio is 47, and it has increased by 6% from the previous year.
The Auditor General also reviewed the payroll of the local governments and discovered that 1.12 billion shillings was paid to 635 ghost staff in 78 local governments. 7.32 billion shillings was deducted from staff salaries as payee, but was never remitted to Uganda Revenue Authority.
What we observed was that about 7.32 billion that was deducted from the salaries of staff was retained and not paid out to URA in respect of pay as you earn, as was required by the law. 78 local governments paid a total of 1.1 billion to 635 staff who had either retired, had been transferred, absconded, or died hence causing financial loss to government.
The report was handed over to the Deputy Speaker of Parliament, Anita Among, who committed on behalf of Parliament to probe all audit queries and bring culprits to book.
We're also going to have you audited. Yes. And we'll also have Auditor General. Of course, Auditor General's office is our office of Parliament. And it would be our pride that we show by example.
Yes.
So we are going to have Auditor General's office also audited, and I think clerk will be communicating to you.
Under Works, government incurred a wasteful expenditure of 17 billion shillings in form of interests and penalties due to delayed payment of contractors. Government has also accumulated 10.22 billion shillings in commitment fees in two projects.